Welcome to Sports, everybody. I'm Chris Saunders. The Bahamas Olympic team wrapped up a reception at the prestigious Claridge's Hotel in London last night, probably one of the final events before the opening ceremony tomorrow, which you can get right here on ZNS TV 13. The reception was hosted by BTC executives and also there, Minister of Youth, Sports and Culture, Dr. Danny Johnson.
Recently, when you'll get back, you'll see we started a new program called Sports Nation, and I have branded the Bahamas as the number one sports nation in the world. Why? We punch way above our weight class. There is no other country in this world with our little population that has done what we have already done. And so I challenge you young people in here tonight to go ahead and do more. That is what this is all about. We're here to support you. Anything you need, just let us know. We think it's going to be a fabulous game. This is going to be fantastic. We're expecting great things, and great things are going to happen.
You know, when we launched our 4G network in the Bahamas, we had a tagline, blazing speed, right? Blazing speed. But as we look around at our things today and what they've done in the past, you guys really changed that whole concept for me. Blazing that became amazing speed because of what you guys do. Ready for our eyes, I'm sure you're going to show us and the world and BTC exactly how fast you really are and how good you really are in your various of events.
That $100,000, that $20,000 will have a ripple effect on our country and development, and you're going to see and hear the benefits.
Remember, ZNS Bahamas, TV 13 and Radio Bahamas are your exclusive broadcasters for the Olympic Games. Starting tomorrow at 4 o'clock with the opening ceremony right here on TV 13, we'll be the only broadcaster in the Bahamas that will be bringing it to you live and not tape delayed like some of the other stations. So make sure check out the opening ceremony for this year's Olympiad right here on ZNS TV 13 starting tomorrow at 4. We'll have round-the-clock coverage starting tomorrow as well with all the action throughout all 27 disciplines being contested at the Olympic Games. Some other basketball news now. The Bahamas Blue Marlin Sports Club giving Bahamian youngsters an opportunity to showcase their basketball skills against top-notch teams. Charles Fisher tells us more.
It's a high school basketball explosion featuring teams from the Bahamas and the U.S.
What we're doing is having a second annual high school basketball tournament. They're bringing in 12 teams from the U.S., 4 girls team and 12 boys team, and we're matching those teams. We have the national junior girls and boys team being a part of the tournament. AU really will go to 16, 8-16 for indoor tournaments, but we would have for this particular tournament, we would just have some of, you know, a regular tournament from ages 14 to about 18. We allow some of the locals to get in. They'll also be coming with college female and boys coaches, male and female coaches. Also be looking at some of the local talent here.
24 teams, 40 games, July 31st through August 3rd, bouncing between Loyola Hall and the Donald Davis Gym.
Last year, it went well, even though it was a challenge, because, you know, last year around this time, we had the CBC National, so that detracted a lot from it, and, you know, we couldn't get any of the major gyms. But they still saw the potential and what it was. The tournament was well received, and the training session, I think, was well received. Last year, we had Gannon Baker. He's an internationally world-renowned trainer. He trained like Kobe Bryant, LeBron James, work at his camp. D. Brown work at his camp, but he trained Stevie Francis. This year we have coming Allen Stein. And if you were to go on to www.strongteam, you would see more about Allen Stein. And these guys revolutionized basketball training. These are the persons that make the NBA players who they are.
And basketball not the only sport these coaches are interested in watching Bahamians play.
Even better next year, we're already planning to have it online, you know, where you can view this live around the world. So, you know, one of the good things is they're not only interested in basketball, also football, American football, baseball, are some of the things we're talking about, and soccer. So we hope that this would be a stepping stone to great things between the Bahamas and U.S. high school.
Last year, Noble out of New Providence won the boys' division. Girls was won by the visiting team from the United States. For ZNS Total Sports, I'm Charles Fisher.
All right, Fisher, thanks a lot. From sailing, organizers of the North Duluth Regatta are wasting no time in planning for this year's event. Starting things off, they've launched their fundraising drive starting with this coming weekend.
First of all, we're going to be having a boat cruise on the motor vessel Lady Rosalind II. And that boat cruise is going to kick off all of the fundraisers that we're going to be having here in Nassau. The response is overwhelming. A lot of people are planning on coming out to that boat cruise. It's sponsored by the Bahamas Fast Ferries and the Burns House Company Limited. So we have lots of giveaways. So I'm intriguing people from Bannerman Town in the south to Spanish Wells, Current Island, Harbor Island in the north. Please come out to this boat cruise. It's going to be one of the best boat cruises you've ever seen.
Talking about regattas, come next weekend, there will be four regattas on the calendar: Acklands, Cat Island, Rollville, and Black Point Exuma. So stay tuned. We'll try to provide coverage of all of those. That'll do it for sports, though. I'm Chris Saunders. Your final look at weather is still to come.